And the next question is, what's the best way to slice samples in FL Studio? So there's one good thing that I like about FL Studio is that you can do the same thing in multiple ways. So you can have several ways to do the same thing in FL Studio, and that gives you a lot of flexibility when you are working with a DAW. And knowing all of those methods really gives you a lot of flexibility when you are producing. So let's jump into FL Studio so that I can explain you. So let's say that you have here a pattern, and you created some stuff here. It's empty, but the idea here is, let's say you want to rename this pattern. It's called pattern one. If I go here, I click on the menu there, and we have here rename and color. And you can see that we have F2. So if I go here, let's do that. Let's do rename and color. Let's call this renamed. Okay. And you can see now it's called renamed. If I click on F2, it gives me another thing, and I will put renamed. If I now clicked on shift and right click, it goes up again, and I call now renamed. And if I click on the mouse wheel, there's a button usually. If I do this, we get another thing. So you see that we have four different ways to do the same thing in FL Studio, which I really, really enjoy. And it's one of the best things that I like about FL Studio is that you have a lot of flexibility when it comes to do stuff. So going back to the sample thing, let's have a clean one. The way that I like to do the way that I like to work with samples is using Slicex. And let's open up Slicex here. We have Slicex. Another thing that I like to use, or you can use, not that I like, but you can use, is Fruity Slicer, which is kind of the same principle of Slicex, but it has a little bit less, how can I say, it's a little bit harder to work with. And I wouldn't use this one too much. If I were to choose, I would choose Slicex every day of the week, because it's a little bit more advanced and easier to control. So let's bring some samples. Let's go here. Let's go to drums, and let's do loops. Where are loops? No, let's go loops, and let's bring a simple sample here just to get an idea. So as you can see by the output that they gave us, FL Studio, we have both the same thing for all of the, both the Slicex and Fruity Slicer. They gave me the same result. So one thing that I like to do is, not that I like to do, as you can see, they would give me the same slice components. So we have here, let's listen to this one. As you can see, it's pretty much the same slices, but here it's a little bit harder for me to control. So to check or to move the slice back and forth is really hard to do. So as you can see, we can have this. We can still split the sample. So if I go, let's say in this point here, at this point I want to split the sample, I could go here and split it. There's also this copy to audio clipboard, which is really cool. Let's say that I want to do, I can copy this and I can go to the sample, and can I paste this? No, I can't. Maybe I would have to do something else with the sample, but yeah, you can copy samples and maybe put them in Edison or something like that. But here in Slicex, as you can see, I still have the same slices for the sample, but I have way more control. I can zoom in, which I cannot do zooms here in Fruity Slicer. I can go, let's take the auto dump. I can go really, really into the sample and really make the arrangement or the selection that I want. Let's say that I want it right there. I can go really, really precise into the point where I want to do the sample. I can have specific regions for specific or specific envelopes for every single slice that I have. I think Slicex is a way more advanced plugin in terms of slicing. And yeah, I mean, I would use this one all the time instead of this slicer. And I think to be honest, I don't see too much future in this one, in slicer, fruity slicer, and I see a lot of future in Slicex. So if I were image line, I would probably discontinue this sometime in the future, but I guess some people still use it. But yeah, I would recommend to only use Slicex. It's more advanced, has more features, and it gives you way more functionalities. The third method that I would use is to go here, drag it into the playlist, and just slice it. So you can just go ahead. If you click on Shift and Alt GR, you can move outside of the grid, and you can go, let's say that I want to slice there, that I want another there, and another there. Let's say that I just want all of those samples. Let's, by the way, cut here. Okay, so I don't want that, neither that. So now I could go here and start making my own drum pattern. So let's make this shorter. So as you can see, it's really easy to slice things up in FL Studio, and it's really, really cool. You can But I would use either the playlist or I kind of prefer to use the patterns here. Let's go here. I kind of prefer to use the Groover, or not the Groover. The Groover is the name of the loop. But I prefer to use Slicex because I can pitch, I can apply envelopes, which I cannot do here in the playlist. But still, you can go here and change the pitch here of the sample. And you can even put like different modes to get different types of stretching. And this you cannot do with Slicex. So there's always pros and cons regarding this type of ways to sample stuff. But it also depends on what you are looking for. So for drums, I usually go for Slicex, but as you can see, this gives you also a really cool feature here in terms of time stretching in the modes that you use. This can give you a different vibe of the samples. And as you can see, you would not guess that this would came from here. So this actually gave a different vibe to the loop, which I really like. Okay, give a little bit of swing. Let's make this a little bit. So as you can see, this sounds a little bit better, and it's a different loop or a different type of drum. So a way to mask that you are using sample drums would be to use this time stretching with these different modes, and you can go ahead and experiment with different modes.